You can bet your bottom dollar. Great programming coming up next on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Stand by. Hold on. Talk at its finest, coming up next on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. In about 2 minutes, stand by. Guys are talking about. Stand by. A great show coming up next on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network in about 30 seconds. Stand by. Don't go away. Stop. If they're talking about it at the barbershop, we're talking about it here on SME. Great show coming up in about 30 seconds. Don't go away. Stand by. It's time. Sit back, relax, and enjoy another great product on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Yeah!
I trust you, but don't lie to me.
Don't lie.
Don't lie. And my word is bond. I know that we've been working on this bond. I know they won't break it if we keep it strong. Keep it strong. Now am I wrong? I don't wanna lie, cause I don't wanna hurt. Gotta live it up while we on this earth. Cause you never know when you'll be in the dirt. In the dirt. Okay, on my way to success. And I know that I can't be late. Still with my day ones, and that ain't gon' change. Ain't gon' change, ain't gon' change.
If I tell you that I love you, then I love you. If I tell you that I trust you, then I trust you. But don't lie to me.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have tuned in to a live edition of the Lonely Hearts Cafe on Spreaker.com, Team Broadcasting. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the very first episode of the Lonely Hearts Cafe on SME, Stewart Media and Entertainment. The Lonely Hearts Cafe is hosted by two individuals. I am one of those hosts. I am honored to be with you tonight. My name is Christopher Tracy. I am in Tampa, Florida. But I'm only one half of the dynamic duo. The dynamic duo, the main man, is the Honorable Deacon Aloysius Forever Love. Aloysius, are you with us?
Yes, I am. What I go on?
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Deacon is in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And the way this show started out is we wanted to give the ladies a male perspective on issues that they were experiencing in their relationships, matters of the heart. And Honorable Deacon, jump in at any time if I am erred in my description. But what we found out over the 3 years that we've been doing this show is that nothing is unique to a gender. The issues that women go through are there issues that men go through. We have issues that are matters of the heart, and we speak on that. And different times over what I describe as a soap opera, this show, a soap opera, a moving soap opera, living soap opera. Different themes step to the forefront. So we may have male storylines that dominate for a series of weeks, then we may have female storylines that dominate for a few weeks. But we are certainly appreciative of everybody who joins us. Honorable Deacon, is there anything you want to add on those lines before I tell people how they can participate in the show and then recognize some of those in the chat room?
No, we're cool. Let us continue.
All right, all right, all right. All right, so, ladies and gentlemen, there are four ways to participate in the Lonely Hearts Cafe as I sip on my drink for tonight. My drink for tonight is cran grape juice mixed with Havana Club rum. And I only have a little bit of Havana Club left, so it's time to go back to Havana. Let me take a sip.
Mm-hmm.
While I'm going through the ways to join the show, you all go on and pour your drinks, take the opportunity to share the show with your friends. So, ways to participate in the show. Number one, call in. Call in. Not now. Give me a chance to get through the beginning of the show, the first segment, but call into the show. The number never changes. The telephone number is 813-435-5761. Again, 813-435-5761. The second way to participate in the show is to go to the show's Facebook page, Lonely Hearts Cafe. Post a comment there. We'll read your comment and we'll vibe, go along back and forth that way. The third way to participate in the show is to join us on Twitter. Follow us on Twitter. The Twitter ID is at Lonely Heart Calf. At Lonely Heart Calf. So that is certainly another way to participate in the show. Caller who just called from the 334 area code, stay on the line, but turn your phone down a little bit. We're getting some feedback. Stay on the line and we'll be with you shortly. So you can tweet us on Twitter. We'll see the comment, post it, we'll read the comment, and then we'll go back and forth. The fourth way to join us has a life of its own, and it is the chat room. And as I said earlier, the chat room had over 100 comments. It already has, it's up to 142 now. So the way to find the chat room is the majority of you are listening to us through Spreaker.com. On the Spreaker.com app, in the lower right-hand corner, the bottom right-hand corner, there is a comment bubble. First thing I want you to do is hit the heart on the show, liking the show. Second thing I want you to do is follow the show. If you follow the show, you will get our weekly alerts to when shows are starting and when shows are originating. The third thing that I want you to do or encourage you to do is to go to the comment bubble. There's a comment bubble. If you click on that bubble, you will be in the chat room. And the chat room is full of wonderful people right now who are commenting, vibing about the show. And they are active participants to the show. So those are the four ways to participate in the show. And there's another way, the hotline. So those who have the hotline number usually send me text messages, et cetera, et cetera. So we are here. And we are thankful, appreciative of everyone who has joined us tonight. I feel like I'm missing something, Aloysius. Oh! Ladies and gentlemen, this is our first episode on SME, Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. As I said, follow Stewart Media and Entertainment on Spreaker so that you will get alerts to when all of the SME shows broadcast, including Lonely Hearts Cafe. Trust me, you want the entire lineup. So follow SME on Spreaker so that you won't miss any shows. I see that our listeners in Las Vegas have chimed in. Hello to Robert Twix Taylor. I don't know if you guys heard that little ding there, but that was a comment from my Vegas barber, Twix. And we do have a comment from the Vegas market. Now, the Vegas market and the LA market and the Oakland market, they are kind of unique because they're on West Coast time. They're just getting off work. So they are always pushing us, hey, start later, do this kind of thing. But we're certainly glad that they are joining us on the West Coast. So one thing I want you guys to do is follow us, participate in the chat room. And those in the chat room are getting ready to get in and recognize you guys. But I want you all to shout out your cities. Let me know where you're chatting from. Let me know where you're participating from. So I'm going to go to the Honorable Deacon. But first, we already have a caller from the 334 area code. I just want to check and see who it is. Caller from the 334 area code. Who are you?
Sunshine in the house. Just wanted to say hello to everybody.
Sunshine! Aloysius.
Hey.
Hello.
Hi, Aloysius.
Sunshine.
Yes.
This is your first time joining us this season.
Yes, and I'm glad you reminded me.
We're glad to have you. I've got our ladies from Raleigh just joined us. Who do we have, Tiana and Teresa, or one or both?
Both.
Very good. Welcome, ladies. Welcome. Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you. You said welcome, welcome, welcome.
Aloysius?
Yes, sir.
How are things in Grand Rapids?
Cold and rainy.
Why is it
and
still
I think
cold?
My mechanic has a strange-ass attitude. For some reason, he loves my car more than I do, and he wants it back in there. So,
how long has he had your car?
How many times
in a month has he had your car?
He's had it for 2 weeks of this between the 2 months already, and it has to go back in. So, you know,
what's
he
supposed
gives
to be wrong
me
with
the
it?
Line. I think the radiator blew out at this time, but he did the underlining under the shaft and whatnot. And then he gives me the speech, oh, you haven't owned the NW, they cost money. And I was like, man, fuck that. Just fix my goddamn car. And I'm not trying to hear all the bullshit.
How long have you been dealing with this mechanic?
About 2 years.
Okay.
And then maybe time to move on. Because,
I was gonna say, do you trust him?
Yeah, I know.
I'm gonna tell you what you do. You go to him and you play the song that MC that we led off tonight as our theme. Mm-hmm. And you say, you tell him, don't lie to me. Don't lie to me.
I'm not gonna fix it.
If you tell me you ain't gonna do shit, just don't do shit. But don't lie to me. You know.
Yeah, he's a cool little Asian dude, but this is, like I said, it may be time to keep it moving.
What does him being Asian have to do with it? First of all, is your car an Asian car?
It's a German European car. So
you got an Asian dude working on a German car?
Yeah, but they tend to know what he tends to know what he's doing, basically.
With computers,
you know, and it's more of a reputation here in the city, you know, as far as getting things done, you know, like he'll get things done, but it's like in his own time compared to a lot of other people, where they'll bullshit you for like a month or two, and so you're like, well, what the fuck, you know? But
how long has he had your car again?
I've had this car.
How long has he had your car?
2 weeks and it's going right back.
So most people bullshit you for a month or two, and he's going on 2 weeks of the bullshit.
Because they have to order the parts, and they have to figure out how to do it. You know, it's that type of bullshit.
Figure out how to do it.
It's not,
what is he watching YouTube
if it's
videos?
Yeah, I was about to say they better get on YouTube and do something, because my shit needs to be together like yesterday. You know, I mean, I know other ways around the city, don't get me wrong, but goddamn.
See, if you weren't so mean to those ladies up there, then,
yeah, fuck that. Okay. I'll get my shit done my way, and they can all kiss my ass. You know what I mean?
All right. So, anything else going on with the ladies? Any relationship ordeals? Any interesting sightings at work?
Well, let me tell you something. Well, this is the dumb shit that happened Saturday. I was at my the beginning board meeting. No, it was before the board meeting. And this chick comes to my house and asks to borrow a phone. Like one of my old phones, you know, an old smartphone. So I'm saying to myself, okay, this is the dumbest shit I've ever heard, but fuck it, I'll see where it goes. And I think that she thinks that by getting this phone, she owns a part of me and I'm supposed to be like calling her or some shit. Mm-hmm. And I guess today when she sees me, I'm supposed to be like, hey, how you doing? And I really didn't, you know, I saw her, but I didn't really give her enough attention. She got mad about that shit, you know.
She got mad?
And yeah, she got mad.
Okay.
And so I'm still trying to figure out, you know, what the fuck A, getting my phone wasn't going to do for her, and knowing that she probably has about a billion phones at her house, but I don't know. Maybe, you know, maybe that's just her way of saying that I need to pay her more attention. And secondly, she shouldn't have just shown up at my shit, you know what I mean? Because I was, like, in the middle of a meeting. And usually, I kind of snapped on her about doing that from the beginning.
Why are you snapping on the ladies? Why can't there just be peace and love in your world?
That's just the nature of the beast.
Snapping on them,
at the present moment.
Snapping on them, Aloysius, is not going to get you anywhere with them. We don't want to slow your vibrations.
I don't want... A majority of the time, I don't want their energy in my life anyway. So... It doesn't really matter. And if I play into whatever they're feeling, then I'm just losing out on the energy that I have from the beginning anyway.
But Aloysius, don't you realize that if you are nicer to the ladies, more accommodating, and absorb some of their energy and invite some of their energy within your realm, your heart may not be lonely anymore, and then we can close the cafe.
Yeah, so fuck that and fuck that. that's not gonna happen. You know what I mean?
Okay. Well, good news to the listeners: the cafe will remain open because Aloysius does not give a fuck.
I mean, how? Well, see, the thing that you have to look at is A, that I'm not from the city. I'm not from the state, and you have to be real careful as far as the conversation and the people that you keep around you.
Ain't nobody from there.
Oh, well, that might be true too, but it puts you in bad situations. So, because like when I first got here, the thing was, all the women get low. I don't know if you know what that means, but there will be some scandals.
You tell me, because when you said get low, I was thinking some drug shit. And then when you said get low, then I was thinking of a blowjob. Then you saying get low, I was thinking of they getting down. Ladies and gentlemen, this is really what went through my mind. The third thing that went through my mind just that quickly is getting low means getting down on your all fours in a club for a female and eating another woman's pussy. So which one of those is correct?
That you remember that thing, I think it was on Lil' Kim's album where she invited the guy to the hotel and the guys were in the hotel room already and they robbed her.
Yeah.
So they do real scandalous shit here. You know, you will be fucked up and fucked over fucking around, basically. Mm. So you have to be real careful, and the nicer that certain women are, the worse positions that they put you in. As far as being here, I'm not going to say everywhere in the world, don't get me wrong. But I know certain shady chicks, and I know a lot of chicks here that are extremely shady, you know.
Mm-hmm. So, Aloysius, you let me know if I need to come up there and be your chauffeur for a couple of days, because I'm sure I it's about time for me to observe what's going on up there. But the one problem that I do have with what you said is that you said the temperature was cold. What's it doing still being cold?
It's Michigan. It's Michigan, brother. We're right here by all the lakes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So now I'm going to recognize some of the people in the chat, and we are up to 253. That was the alcohol talking, you all. 253 posts in the chat room. So Easy Does It. Easy Does It's in the chat room. Thank you for joining us. Spicy from Spicy Conversations. Queen B is joining us from Kentucky. Spicy is in ATL. Easy Does It, let me know where you're from. I'm going to go through this kind of quickly, you all. Ronnie is joining us from Sheboygan, Wisconsin. Chief Rocker Jersey Vern, who left off the number one, so I don't know if he's the chief tonight or the assistant chief. Chief Rocker Jersey Vern is joining us from ATL. Gary G. Money Joiner, my main man, is in the chat room also. He's from the ATL. Scrolling through. Sunshine is joining us. She's from the 27. Sunshine in the house. Bus a bus is in the house. Bus a bus is joining us from Oklahoma. OKC is in the house. Everybody who hasn't posted your cities and where you're from, post them by the time I get to you. Grego is in the house. Grego, I think, is in the ATL, although he loves the Patriots. New England Patriots, that is. Okay. The LP show is in the house. LP show is in the house, and he will be calling in later. I expect him to be calling in. Give us about 20, 30 minutes before you call in, and we're certainly looking forward to that. We have some questions to ask him. He is a professional masseuse. Sunshine, don't you like a good massage?
I need one right now.
What part of your body do you need massage? No. Let me ask the question professionally as they ask. Are there any parts of your body that are giving you trouble?
All over.
All over?
All over.
All under.
Up and above.
All outside.
All around.
And all inside.
And dick in your life. You need dick in your life.
We have a new person in the chat room, Lois Lucius.
Mm-hmm.
And she ain't lying. So let us know where you're from, if I may say, sweetheart. Sosa's in the chat room. That's a new person also. Welcome, Sosa. Willie Bird, new to the chat room. Welcome, Willie. You all let me know where you all are from, and we certainly thank you all for joining us. Sluggo's in the house. Sluggo is the hammer. 334 Bama Boy. 334 Bama Boy is from the Gump, Montgomery, Alabama. But he spends a lot of time across the bay from me in St. Pete, Florida. Okay. We have a full bank of topics tonight as I continue to go through the chat. Everybody's speaking to each other. There's a conversation going on that's being moderated by the Chief Rocker. Sandra from Huntsville, Alabama, is in the chat room, I see. And I know that I pronounced her name correctly tonight, Ronnie. Hi, Sandra. Welcome back. Okay. And I'm continuing to scroll down. Usually, you could tell when Chief Rock is in the chat room because it's a Aloysius.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody you need to meet is in the chat room. Curvaceous Candy is in the chat room, and I think this might be Curvaceous's first time joining us in the chat room or joining us on the Long Hearts Cafe. Where are you going to be on Saturday, Hobbs? Midnight Kyle has joined us from Texas, from the Dallas market. Thank you, Midnight Kyle. Jamie is in the house, Ronnie's son. Jamie, shouting out from Sheboygan as well. Welcome. So Ronnie's going to be on her P's and Q's tonight because her son is in the chat room. That ninja has joined us in the chat room. Ninja is in Huntsville, Alabama. Coldest piece on earth, says the universe has opened. Indeed. Cowpote, my main man Cowpote. Cowpote says busy night. Cowpote is joining us from Minnesota as well. And Curvaceous says yes, this is her first time joining us. The Empress. Is that a booty? Y'all excuse me one second while I look and see if this is a booty. What is that? Goddamn. Oh, it's a peacock. It's not a booty. It's a peacock. Oh, my goodness.
Take your time and work through it, brother.
Have you seen it?
Yes, I have.
Man.
It's a nice tattoo, too.
Wait, who said that? Teresa?
Said what?
Clearing your throat.
Oh, yeah, that was me. I'm sorry.
Okay. What's in your throat?
Nothing. Now.
When's the last time you had something in your throat, down your throat, in your mouth?
I ate.
No, no, no.
I had some food.
I ain't talking about that. When was the last time you had?
Well, that's it.
When last time you had?
It's been 30 days.
No. I'm sweating from the Empress's tattoos. Well, oh, my goodness. Somebody get the 411 on the Empress. Empress, tell us where you're from. First of all, everybody, I'm stuttering now, too. 786 area code. That's Danny. Danny?
Hey.
Danny, how are you?
I am tired.
Tell us why you're tired. Danny is calling from Miami, everybody. Say hello from Miami. Danny, why are you tired tonight?
I'm just leaving the gym.
Still going to the gym. Yeah.
Get some games.
What's going on in the gym? What did you do at the gym tonight? Did you do some cardio? Did you lift weights? Did you people watch?
I did. My trainer had me doing sumo squats and Ubering. Yeah, it's when you hold this thing. I call it Ubering. I make it fun.
No, Ubering is when you ride. Ubering is when you ride. So you've been riding motherfuckers at the gym?
Well, no, I ride at home. I don't ride at the gym. But Ubering is when you drive. So you hold up this thing that looks like a steering wheel. It's a weighted steering wheel. Oh. And you do it like a car. And then
is it a stick
I think
chair?
That's it.
Is it raining down there?
No. Not now. It was pouring down earlier.
What's that pulsating out here?
Me not wearing a seatbelt.
Okay. All right. Well, be careful. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, Aloysius, the Honorable Deacon.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Here is the first question. What makes a man give up parental rights to his biological children? That comes from Queen out of Louisville. What would make a man give up biological rights to his children? Anybody in the chat room, feel free to comment. We'll read your comments on the air. Honorable Deacon.
Ignorance.
Ignorance from...
Well, not necessarily so.
Okay. There we go. We already have a debate.
Hey, it's Invictus baby mama.
Hold on. Let the Honorable Deacon go first. Go ahead.
It all depends on the situation. Like, if you meet somebody at a club and you get them pregnant that particular night and you see that they're a person full of lies and bullshit, then I would say that you might not want to be a part of it. There are some reckless people in this world that will put you in bad situations.
But, Honorable Deacon, you know the
I know you're going to say the baby doesn't have anything to do with it, but at the same time...
You might have to save the baby from the bullshit.
Well, shit. How many babies do you save?
I'm about to mute.
I'm just saying, though, You don't put yourself in a bad situation because of one night of pleasure either, though. You know what I mean? So, or she could have been lying from the beginning and saying that it was somebody else's baby and then comes back so many years later and says, well, it's yours. Then, you know, if you don't have a connection with the child from the beginning, then what do you do? You know, and then she says, well, I'm moving on with my life. We don't need you in our life. And she was no good from the beginning. And she just wants you to sign the paperwork and you've never really been bothered with the child anyway.
Aloysius said, bothered with the child. Now,
you know what I'm saying.
I stick with my comment. I love you like a brother, but, well, maybe not a brother, but you know what I mean. But, hey, I'm sticking with the ignorance.
It's pronounced lover.
I'm going to tell you what's going to come your way. Okay. Cowpoke says, is going to say strap it up. Okay. If you strap it up, you won't have to worry about that. Okay. So that comment is going to come also. But, I'll give you a scenario, too. What if the woman, what if it was one of those one-night stand situations where you really didn't know the female, and the woman ends up getting married to someone else, and the child is under 3 years old, the woman wants the husband to have the relationship with the child and be in the child's life. So the husband is going to adopt the child, and the mother wants you to relinquish parental rights. That's another scenario where that's one scenario I can see it.
Think about like if the child needs a kidney.
There's a lot of ignorant women out there. You can come back and ask for a kidney.
No.
And then Sandra in the chat room gave a scenario also of military. Now, I've never been in the military, and I'm not sure how it works, but I know that women sign their children over. Help me out, Sunshine.
Yeah, we do, but it's temporary based on the fact that you might be deployed. It's not full, total custody. It's based on deployment. And yep. But you still support the child financially. It's not a total neglect of the child. You still have to financially support that child, even if you are giving your custody, because that's the right, that's what you have to do in the military if you're not married. But even if you are married, you still have to make sure that your spouse is willing to be a full-time, you know, because some husbands don't understand full-time work, so some people still give their child to their parents and things like that while they're deployed. But you still are financially responsible for the child. And not only, I don't know.
Hold on. Well, 99 years is temporary, too.
Yeah.
So what if you're drugged and raped by a booger bear? What's that about?
Well, you need to go to the cops.
And she gets pregnant, and then, you know, the whole situation.
So let me slow the Honorable Deacon down. Alcohol is a drug. So what if you are drugged, and who amongst us has not been raped by a woman before?
I've never been raped by a woman, thank you, Jesus.
And we know some women are booger bears.
And you call it rape.
What'd you say, Hobbs?
What happened?
Hobbs, let me tell you what he does. He unmutes his phone, yells out a comment, and then puts the phone right back on mute.
What did he say?
He said, can you call that rape?
Oh.
Hobbs, a woman can rape a man, okay? When you are international men of leisure, like myself and the Honorable Deacon Aloysius, forever love, it happens. Sometimes you have to tell a woman no. Sometimes you have to hold your penis so that the woman won't put it inside her.
What?
Sometimes you have to tuck your tail and run.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sometimes a woman can be, Hobbs, I'm telling you this, you're my cousin. Sometimes a woman will be sucking your dick and you just have to tell her stop. Okay?
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's so depressing. I really would like to just pray for her, okay. Whoever she
is. It's reality.
It is reality. So, topic number two. Would you, Honorable Deacon, would you call off the wedding if you found out that your fiance cheated during her bachelorette party?
Well, yes. Because that really expresses her will just to be with me singularly. And if she's giving it up because this goes back into the intoxication thing and people taking advantage of you, I guess. But or whether she's completely sober and she just gives it up, that would be kind of strange too.
Queen B says marriage and lonely marriage and Aloysius does not go in the same sense, go together in the same sense. Lord, that's alcohol. Let me try it again. Now I know what's wrong with Jersey Vern when he's reading chat. Marriage and Aloysius does not go together in the same sentence.
No, this is true. This is true. It's not my cup of tea.
So
I understand the concept. I'm just not willing to go through that.
So you would call it off?
I would. I wouldn't have called it on, but yes, I would call it off.
Hobbs, are you ready to comment?
I'm ready.
If a woman, if your fiance slept with somebody else at her bachelorette party and you found out about it, would you call it off?
So essentially, it has to be. It's no different than if it happened 6 months ago. I mean 6 months, 2 months, night before. I don't see any difference.
So you would?
Roger.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's right before. Right? It's right. 6 months ago, yeah. 6 months ago, yeah. 2 months ago, 2 years. I have a loan. You choose the night before.
y'all act like sex is the only reason to get married.
Is that the only bitch in the world, though? I mean, shit. If she's fucking other people, you just got to be like, okay, that's some simping ass shit to do. You know what I mean?
Well, do you expect yourself to be faithful? First of all, I shouldn't be asking you this kind of question because you.
And I thank you. Shit.
Caller from the 612 area code. 612 area call. Who just joined us?
Gentlemen, how are you?
What's going
hey, what's
on?
Happening?
So, yeah. How you doing, Jeff? So,
good.
If a woman cheated on you,
yeah.
Oh no, I didn't say cheated. If she slept with somebody else during the bachelorette party, would you break
that
up?
Would, well, here's the deal. Here's the deal. That would never happen because I've been at a bachelor party one time with a friend of mine years ago, and he was going to get married. He went off the stripper. I promptly left. I wouldn't hang out with people like that. I've been to Vegas with friends that are married.
Yeah.
And they went and screwed around. I don't run with people that cheat on their wife. I don't do it with my wife. My ex-fiance for my wife now, best thing she ever did, she cheated on me. I took the ring off her finger to get the hell out. You know, I mean, I don't run with people. It's the best thing ever happened. I said, give me the ring. Get your sorry ass out of my house. You're a hoe. I mean, men and women don't change. They don't want, once they cheat, they always cheat. If you're a cheater, you'll always be a cheater. You're a drug addict, you're drunk, you're an a-hole, you're prejudiced, pay whatever it may be. But I wouldn't run with somebody like that because I trust myself, but I don't want to be with somebody and have to look his wife in the eye that I know he's out porking somebody in Las Vegas. You know, you want to be mean with minor sex, fine. Do that when you're single. When you're married, you look her in the eye and you say, hey, I'm going to be faithful.
Okay.
So I don't get that behavior. That would never happen. Like I said, I've been a couple. That stuff happens. My wife was at a bachelorette party.
Yeah.
The grandma, her mom, and the bride all slept with the dancer. Okay.
The same dancer got all three of them.
All three of them.
Three generations in one night.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. Hang on.
Who the fuck are they?
Yes. Yeah.
Shit.
Hang on a second.
She must have been a bad bitch.
But no, they all got them. They all got the big schlong. I mean, it was, and I don't get that. My wife left. All three pounded on the guy, you know. And he impregnated the bride. That was the best thing about the whole thing. That was the best thing. I tell you what, it's like, let's go for 3-for-1. Now let's lay some pipe, huh? I said, love, okay, let's get the grandma, let's get the mama, let's get the bride, huh?
How old is the child now?
Wow, child's 20 years old now because they didn't last. Here was the problem. She was white. The dancer was black. They
so
found
you couldn't
out
hide
when she,
that.
When she had the baby, when you she had the baby, it came out black, and that he knew that's enough. So all of a sudden, she thought, you know, what do you call it? The baby? Would you do your honeymoon baby? But she found out when all of a sudden I'll pop curly hair and dark
hey,
skin. Uh oh, SpaghettiOs.
Jeff. No wonder the stripper slept with three generations.
Yeah, I tell you what. I mean, bad. Like I said on my podcast, you want to dig in that trench, put on a trench coat. Girls give a thrill, get on the pill. But I don't mean, like I said, meanest. Well, we all donated sperm when we were young for money. I get that behavior. Anybody can father a child. I can father. Well, I did, but way back when. But it is what it is. Well, that's way, you know, back then you want some money. You squeeze a few off, you make a couple $100, and it is what it is. You father children, you have to worry about it. The point is, anybody can father a child. Anybody can. Being a dad's holding a pail of fish. And I'll tell any woman out there, when they're pounding away on you, that could be the father of your child. Think twice.
Okay, I got to ask one question. I don't know if you know the answer to this, but I got to tie this all together like a Seinfeld episode.
Go ahead.
Did the stripper waive his parental rights?
What?
Did the stripper wave?
I have no idea. That's water. I have no idea. But I guess if I'm gonna be fathering a child, I'm gonna be the father. I'm gonna be the dad. Like I said, I'm sick and tired of seeing women pushing around kids with no wedding rings.
Okay.
You know, I'm sick and tired of seeing that behavior. No, I wouldn't waive it. If I was a father of a child, I'd be the dad. I mean, I know a friend of mine has been a father of the children, his two kids for 25 years. He never married. He's always been in the child's life. He's always went directly to pay her child support. She's married. They're both married, but they're both the children's lives.
Okay, you know, so one final question before we transition to the other topic. I've heard of guys squeezing one out, rubbing one out for cash. How much do they pay? How much did they pay back in the day?
Well, I think it was $400 a spank. So, who knows? I mean, it was the old days, like plasma, but yeah, you're 20 years old, you want some cash, what the hell? Someone wants to have your seat, go ahead. Just, you can't contact you, you sign away, you become a couple of lesbians, some kid, and you're done.
Aloysius, have you ever done that?
I don't think they would allow me to do that. My kids would be like, extremely crazy.
I gotta get going. I gotta pick up at Delta. You guys have a good show. Shout out to Spicy Girl.
Hey, Capo. Jeff.
That was like a whirlwind. I like it.
Spicy. I was trying to give him that message, but he dipped out. He dipped out. Shout out to Jeff. Everybody follow his show, Cowpote Podcast. Shout out to Jeff calling in from Minnesota. So, Sunshine, how you like that diversity on the Lonely Hearts Cafe?
Awesome. You know, he made some very valid points. But, that's, I don't know, because women do it all the time. Women marry their freaking husbands, even though they know their husband slept with their ex-girlfriend the night before. They might, you know, torture him for the first tonight, but you got to consummate. So who wants to consummate? You know, I don't know, you know, 6 months before, you can deal with that. But the night before, I had to kill me one. I'm sorry. I might kill him at the altar. I don't know. That wouldn't work out. But just, I'm a little feisty. So I don't think I could forgive that quickly, not overnight, and then know about it and still say I do. I would have to get like a house, I don't know. But women do it all the time, so the double standard with men, and that's the problem. Men say, oh, she's a hoe, but most men on their last night, they've been the finger to stripper, had the dick suck, all that's the same. So, you know, I'm not saying... Women are more forgiving, and I pray that women would choose not to screw the stripper, you know what I'm saying, or their ex, you know, but you never know.
Okay.
Husbands cheat, so what's the difference between the fiancé cheating the night before marriage? I don't know.
Okay, caller from the 706 area code, who do we have with us?
Oh, you got Pico in the house.
Pico caller from the ATL. Pico. So,
what's going on, yeah? Beautiful show.
Sunshine says that, hey, Aloysius, before we get to Pico, called in about two or three weeks ago, but he was at the damn restaurant ordering food. That's, we heard him in the background, like ordering a pizza or some shit like that. So, you may remember that.
Okay. Another quick question. What is the black market? What's the market value of black man's sperm anyway? I didn't even know that was a thing, but anyway.
$25.
I know, right?
So that's what it's like now. Y'all remember the infamous scene on the Real Housewives of Atlanta reunion when Phaedra got at Kenya, was it? And she said that your husband... nutted in a cup so he could have piece of money to give you. So yeah, it's low now. That's why I asked him back in the day, how much was it? Okay. So, Pico.
What's up? What's going on?
Thank you for calling. Sunshine says that she's in need of a massage right now, and I have some professional questions for you. So tell us about your massage business, what you do, and give us a little rundown about you. So some of the ladies, let me tell you what I intend from this. I intend for this man to be flying into your city to rub you down, to please you, to make you feel good. Don't go for no knockoff massages like you would get from the Chief Rock of Jersey, Vern. Get the real thing, okay? Get the real thing from a professional, okay? You don't want to go to one of those places that opens up at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock at night.
Those are the best ones. I'm sorry.
Really?
When I was married, I took my husband to a few of the brothel-type massage parlors, and he really enjoyed it. Just don't fuck my husband, but, it was
Well, could
cool.
they stroke your husband? Could they stroke him off? Could they jack him off? Was
they
that okay?
They did all of that.
Huh?
They did all of that, but I had to sit and watch. I wasn't going to let her, because I didn't trust him that much, you know what I'm saying? Because, a man is a man. So it was part of our little...
Okay, so before we go to the professional, let me ask you, Sunshine, have you ever gone to a brothel type, as you say, and had a man give you a vaginal massage?
No, they're hard to find. I looked for it. When I gave my husband one, I looked for us to get like a couple's, and it was just like women, and I didn't want no women massaging my cats. I just settled and gave him the gift. But, I never could find one or could find somebody that was honest about that they would do it. You know what I mean? Because they were, really undercover. You had to, go through secret doors and make little cold phone calls. So, if you said the wrong thing, they'd hang up on you. You know what I mean?
So this is why I asked Pico to call in today. Okay, you touched on a couple subjects. So let's run through these real quickly. Pico,
what's going on?
have you ever, and you're not on the clock right now, so you can answer these questions off the record.
Okay.
Have you ever given a woman a vaginal massage while on the clock?
Wow.
Ding, 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 ding,
now I'm a professional
ding,
massage therapist now, but I have to be honest, I haven't. But it was upon their request.
Wow.
And they said, are you comfortable with it? I said, well, you're paying for the service. As long as you're comfortable, I'm comfortable.
So that, but all, thing, awesome. All joking, all kidding aside, and fuck you too, Jersey Vern, that's a actual massage technique, right?
Well, actually it is. Actually okay. it is. It's okay. not something that you learn in school, but it's a category in the porn sites,
so it must be legit to me.
Yeah, it's actually, because a lot of women, they might have a procedure on that area, and then you will go and you will massage the scar tissue. So anytime you have any type of surgery, you're going to have scar tissue, and then the tissues need to be manipulated.
Shout out to Tiffany in the chat room, Tiffany from ATL joining us. Tiffany, you need to get a picture, okay? I know you're trying to hide from your family, from your son, from your husband, but Ronnie's in here with her son, okay? So don't be hiding. Make up a picture. Throw up a fake picture like the beautiful woman, sexy woman with the peacock on her hip. So next question.
Okay.
When I think about that peacock, it makes you just want to go to the zoo. I wonder, does peacock taste like chicken?
Mm. Probably acquired taste. I don't know.
Oh, man. Okay. So, I've been called that before, too. Let me see if I have any... questions before I get into my direct questions. So you have massaged the coochie. Women have asked for
it. Yes, I have, and I made some good money doing it too.
So how often does that happen when you get that request on the clock officially?
It's not often.
A couple times a month, a couple times a year.
They don't really want to cross that barrier, and then you don't want to cross that barrier as well, because if you're licensed in the state, you don't want to compromise yourself. So
okay. That's a real question.
Okay.
But I have a question. So do you ask for a full body or head to toe? Because that was like the
question. I ask them, do they want to... I never come in with the intentions of... I just come in with a therapeutic mindset of healing the body.
Okay.
So I would ask for full body.
Oh, okay. I thought so.
The Empress, tell me where you are located. I missed it if you posted it before, but tell me where you are located. And Denise, shout out to Denise from the 27. And Denise, you're supposed to be at work. So shout out. Thank you for joining us tonight. Queen, if I miss the Empress's response, please monitor that for me. I appreciate your assistance. Thank you. And Empress, stay away from Chief Rockus, okay? So, here's my question. Here's my issue. If I call a place to get a massage, I need a massage. And I've got gift cards galore. I've got 2 years worth of gift cards. $50 each. So, I've got like 8 to 12 gift cards.
It's time to go get a massage. What's waiting on?
Okay, here's the problem. When I lived in Milwaukee, I had a nice, professional, African-American female masseuse who I met.
Masseuse or massage therapist?
Well, I don't know. You got to tell me. So here's the thing. That's why I have you on. Okay, so here's the thing.
Right.
I met her at she had the chair. So she was doing free chair massages at a street festival, and she was giving out her card. So the Empress is in Michigan. Aloysius, do you know the Empress?
Not Empress, right offhand. Let's put it that way.
Mm. You know, I don't want to step on any toes. So,
no, I have no clue.
I will lick them, though. So, what city in Michigan, Empress? Keep working on that, Queen Bee. So I don't want a man to massage me. Okay? So when I call in,
what man does? Well, never mind.
Well, hold on now. We got to get into this now.
See, that's why I asked him on. Because these are things that I need to know. Okay, so I'll go on and say the place because I don't know where you work. So I'll go on and say the place. And don't disclose where you work, okay? Because we ain't trying to get nobody in trouble, nothing like that. The place is, what's this place called? Massage Lux, L-U-X-E, right? National chain.
Okay.
So when I call there, they always, want to schedule an appointment, blah, 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 blah. Okay. I really want to ask them, can I have a woman touch me? Is that legit? Am I able to make that request?
Of course. This is your massage. This is your hour, 90 minute, 2 hour sports, deep tissue, Swedish. It's yours. It's customized to what you want.
Okay. Yes.
So you can definitely have a woman. Yes, you can definitely have a woman.
Am I able to tell her that the area of tension or stress is my penis?
Your groin area.
Now, this is what I was saying about that. No, you couldn't go into a spa and get that type of treatment. You would have to get a business card from somebody that, just say you went and got a massage at Lux or whatever. Mm-hmm. You got the massage. You asked, can I get your business card if you really enjoyed the massage? And then from there, it just depends on what type of rapport that you're having with the therapist. But you're not going to go into any public establishment and get that type of massage unless it's already set up, like she was saying, the brothel type, which is, those are more of masseuses. Because when you're dealing with the spas and the chiropractors, you're dealing with licensed, professional, insured massage therapists.
You got to be careful. But they are crazy.
Yeah, you got to feed off the energy, the rapport you get. And but just to request that over the phone, they might hang up on you.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, they might hang up on you.
So boss lady today told me, she's asked me why I haven't scheduled a massage. And I told her, I don't want a dude massaging me, and I told her, I said, what I'm used to. But boss lady told me that I'm, she said, you might go in there and try to talk to the people. You might be going in there and try to hold a conversation. Now, that's not me. When I go in there, just touch on me, rub me, make me feel good, and I'm leaving. Okay? I'm not trying to have a conversation. I'm trying to go to sleep, actually. Wake me up before I go-go. Okay?
Okay.
So, the other question I had... Okay. Go ahead, Sunshine.
Oh, that was... my voice is deep, but that wasn't me that time.
So, like I said, it depends on your rapport. So, let's say you're getting your massage, and like I said, the energy is just flowing. Then you could be like, well, do you make house calls? And every therapist is going to be like, yeah, I make house calls, because that means now you're a potential private client, somebody I could come to your house and I could service you. Or a lot of therapists have their own spots where people can come to them, and it's a more of a, you know, more intimate setting where you can really, really feel relaxed. But I'll tell you this, though.
It was a little Asian lady.
Hold on one second, Sunshine. I just need to ad lib a little bit here. The Empress says, really? And I said, uh-huh. So this is interesting to all of us. We appreciate you, Pico. So while we talking about the Empress, where is Caledonia? Caledonia is near what city in Michigan? Okay, go ahead, Sunshine.
That can't be too far from here.
I took my husband and an ex-boyfriend. And after my ex-boyfriend, we didn't do it anymore because it got really strange. Because you really have to go into strange places. And they don't really like couples because they get scared, like you're going to take advantage of them. You know what I mean? So you have to be really clear and tell them really what you want. But when I did take my husband, the little Asian lady, she had a bikini. She was really cute. You know what I'm saying? I'm not into women, but she was cute. My husband was digging her. And he was just so, he was nervous, actually, because he couldn't believe that I actually was going to pay for it. You know what I mean? It was his birthday, and she came in, and she asked me a couple of questions, like, you're not going to whoop my ass, are you? And I was like, nah, as long as you don't fuck him, you're good. You know what I'm saying? And she came in there with her hair, a bikini on, and she got to doing the rock star girl stuff, and the hair was slinging, and all over the place. She gave him a shower. You know, they bathe you down, and... it was really interesting. You know, I was turned on by it. It made our night really great.
They do that in those spots?
Yes. They shower. They got to wash you up because they might put their mouth on you. They're not going to just... and they got to make sure you don't have any, like, lesions, I guess, you know, because she really did inspect his whole body prior to actually getting to the masseuse.
Okay, what's going on? But Pico, y'all don't do no bathing in the spots, do you?
No, we're not doing no. Like, you go to maybe a resort or you go to a high-end spot, and they'll have the showers where you're just going to lock them and take the shower, put your robe on, maybe have you know, some water with lime or something, and then you come in for the massage. But no, the therapist doesn't bathe. But one thing I do want to say is, now, when you go into the spa, you can get your glutes worked. And I suggest every man get his glutes work and every woman get your glutes work, because it's so beneficial for your lower back, hamstrings. Because we're sitting on planes, we're sitting in front of computers all day, and all that tension is built up, and you wonder why your back is hurting so bad.
Okay.
Because the way you're carrying your posture. So,
okay, first glute of all, massage, thank you for telling the official therapeutic suggestion shit. And we will take you up on that and getting our glutes work, but we want to know about getting, you know.
My husband reached for a climatic expression.
And did it tell you?
Like I said,
he told all his homeboys, they were like, she's the best wife ever, even though we ended up getting divorced. And he cheated on me with a stripper. But, hey, that's neither here nor there. It was a great experience. And I'll do it again. You know, if I was in a committed relationship, which I'm not now.
Fuck that. You don't have to take somebody that you're in a committed relationship with. You can take your dude.
No, you got to be deserving. You know, it's not just to take anybody.
Speaking of that, we need to get into your...
you know, you just don't do that with anybody.
Speaking of that, we need to ask you.
Let them do it for their damn self. You know what I'm saying? But... not as a gift for anybody.
Okay. Hold on. A couple more questions with Pico. First of all, I want to go back to something that Midnight asked, and I saw a couple people in the chat room commenting on, and I do want to respond to that. With me saying okay. that I needed a woman or wanted a woman, there was a question that someone asked, what if the woman was a stud? So I'm going to give you guys my honest Christopher Tracy answer on this, and it may shock some people. Christopher Tracy does not have a problem with a stud, okay? Now, let me tell you this. Christopher Tracy loves ass and hips. In fact, that may be one of the only things that Christopher Tracy respects is ass and hips. If you don't have ass and hips, Christopher Tracy ain't going to deal with you. So if a stud has ass and hips, that is a great situation for me, and Boss Lady will appreciate that because the woman has no interest in me. So if a stud has ass and hips, I'm down with that. It's great. If she doesn't have ass and hips and she looks like a little boy, I can't fuck with you. Okay? Next, Switch. I'm out. Charge me for this visit, but we got to do something better next time. I won't need your services today. Okay. So two
but listen,
questions.
Listen, Christopher Tracy, yeah. You have to get over your preconceived notions about getting a massage from another man because
hold on.
Hey, you gotta put it out there now.
No, you ain't gotta put shit out there. In the words of Aloysius, in the words of Aloysius, no the fuck I don't.
Aloysius, you too, my brother. You need to go get you a massage. You get you a sports massage from a male.
There's nothing sexual about it. Let me tell you something. I played tennis in college, and I loved getting sports massages from the lady.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Now I've had a massage, a professional massage by a woman, but it was just more like going to the gynecologist almost. It was just like procedural. So it is a difference when you go into a true professional than what I'm discussing.
I love when Queen B has my back. Queen B said, hell, you got Chris about the clown. No, the fuck he don't. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so Pico, a couple questions. So number one, before we wrap up, I want you to let the listeners, particularly the ladies, okay, know how to get in touch with you or how you can get in touch with them because I want you traveling around giving massages. The Empress says she needs one. She's in Caledonia, Michigan. You know, Jersey Vern posted his phone number, but you don't need his phone number. Okay, Jersey Vern trying to give his phone number out to everybody. Okay, so that's what. thank you, Queen Bee. Okay, so Sandra said if you're secure with your manhood, then it shouldn't be a problem. Okay, Sandra. Okay, so the couple questions I have for you.
Okay.
Number one, when a person goes to get a massage, what should they wear? I want to show up in a robe, and those who know me know I will show up in a robe.
I suggest anybody that's going to get a massage wear something comfortable. But when you're getting ready to get on that table, get butt naked so you can just really enjoy the experience. That's what I would suggest.
Now, I did read online today that you are welcome to, proper etiquette can be anywhere from fully clothed to everything off, or they say about 50% of the people keep underwear on. Because they're going to put the little drape over you anyway, right?
Yeah, you're going to be professionally draped.
Okay.
So whether you have underwear on or if you don't, but I'm going to tell you this, you should really have the underwear off so the therapist can really work all the cracks and crevices and you can get that full massage.
Yes. Yes. Are you coming to sell?
But it's up to your comfort level, though. It's up to your comfort level as well.
What is a proper tip? What is a good tip? No, I don't want to know what a good tip is. I want to know what is a great tip.
Great tip. Oh, wow. Definitely not $5, y'all. Let's get this thing together because you're not dealing with food. And when you're dealing with a massage, I'm working your whole body. That means I'm literally moving around the whole table, manipulating tissues, pushing toxins out, getting everything through your lymphatic drain system. So a good tip, $30.
Okay.
Take care of your therapist.
Okay.
How much is your services? And what?
It's usually a dollar a minute.
Yep.
And depending if I have to travel, then travel expenses come in, yes.
Because they have to charge me $1.75 for the masseuse.
Yeah, the masseuse is going to charge you more because you're getting the extra extras.
Okay, so Sunshine, when see, I'm not sure how this goes. Okay, so, and Chief Rocker, you seem like a fellow who probably has gone to one of these seedy places, one of these brothel types.
Why they got to be seedy, yo?
That's why I changed it.
That's a living. They got to make a living.
Yeah, okay. So if you go to one of those spots, how much are they expecting as a tip for a happy ending type thing? I don't know. I'm just asking. You know, if anybody knows, anybody, at one of those spots, how much?
I think she charged me $175. I gave her $2. Because I was like, wow, that's some really deep shit. And I wouldn't have did that for nobody. You know, I wouldn't have did that for nobody watching this shit. So, you know, I gave her $25 tip, which maybe sounds cheap now, but that was like in 97, 98. So it might have been okay for the time. But
Asian Water Spa in Gwinnett, Saturday night.
That's what's up. That might be your
problem. I got a $200 tip for my extra, you know, extra activities. So that was, but I wasn't even expecting that. That's what made it beautiful.
That was. You must have did some really hefty handiwork, baby.
See, Sunshine, you missed a perfect opportunity. Sunshine, you missed a perfect opportunity there, okay? You talking about some extra handiwork, okay? You could have asked if he did anything other than handiwork, okay?
Right, I didn't want to go there, you know what I'm saying?
Why not? It's Lonely Hearts Cafe.
For $200, let him keep his dignity.
So I guess he's asking, did you keep your dignity or did you share your dignity?
I just used my hands. Now, I've had a situation where I'm massaging somebody and they're so turned on that they jump off the table and jump on you. You're like, whoa. And I still got paid for that. And that was beautiful. I was just massaging and the person attacked me. So the lady attacked me. So
See, Hobbs, if you're out there, Hobbs, I told you women attack. Okay.
Yeah, they attack.
I used to work out, but you know,
but he ain't tuck and run. He conceded. He didn't concede. He said, okay, let's do it.
Okay.
I was about to lay my cards out on that one.
And that brought out $200.
Okay. So
no, not on that one. No, the $200 was just straight hands.
Uh-oh.
Okay, Pico, tell the ladies how to reach you,
what's up?
And then we're going to transition. Tell everybody about your services and everything.
All right. I want to thank you all. I am Love Therapeutic Touch. I do a mobile chair and table massage. Some of the modalities that I do are neuromuscular therapy, deep tissue, sports, Reiki, hot stones, facials. And you can reach me. I'm going to actually throw my number out there because it is about networking. So my phone number is 770-376-7662. That's 770-376-7662. And then my email address is insightseeks@yahoo.com. That's insightseeks@yahoo.com.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for taking the time to answer all my questions.
Thank
I didn't
you
want
all.
To make you nervous when I told you I wanted you to come on today, but I appreciate you. I hope I wasn't too intrusive.
Oh, no. But I'm going to tell you, you have all those gift cards, take advantage of it. Especially get your traps work, get your back work. And then if you want that extra stuff at the barber, you can still go there, but you got all those gift cards. Utilize those. Go
and
get you some massages.
Literally, I have like 8 or 9.
I have one more question for Pico.
I'm sure you do.
What's up?
No, this is serious. This lady fooled me, right? If I really want a good massage for back pain, because, you know, I had a bad accident a couple of years ago, I will go.
You don't know that.
But this lady did this, like, touch where she didn't touch me, like she did like a aura type massage, and I don't know if I was high or what, but I thought the shit worked. Which, you know, for like 10 minutes, she just like waved her head around my back and my neck, and I was like, what the fuck is this bitch doing? But she had me so fooled, you know, like the shit was working. I thought it worked. So is that an actual technique, or was the heifer just taking my little...
No, it is an actual technique. It's an energy technique that deals with your chakras. You have 7 chakras in your body. So it's Reiki. She was doing Reiki on you. So what you can do with Reiki is you can beam energy from your hands, and you can do it with touch, too. So usually if you get a Reiki massage, the therapist's hands are going to heat up like an oven.
Do you know
but at the same
that?
Time, if she's hovering over you, mm-hmm. she's beaming energy. So, yes, it's real, but you got to be receptive to it.
Oh, okay. Like, I was receptive, yeah.
Now, you have Aloysius and I our full attention right now. Are you learned in that technique?
I've taken Reiki 1 and Reiki 2. You have to be a Reiki master to be a master. But yes, I do. I 1 and 2, and I'm actually using it in my practice now. And people are like, "Wow, your hands are so hot!"
Yeah.
And it just takes you straight to the part where somebody is whatever pain area they're dealing with. So it's really real. But the therapist has to remove their ego, and then the client has to be receptive to think it's not hocus pocus. Because if your mind says this is hocus pocus,
it won't have any effect.
You have to receive it. If I'm giving you something, you got to be willing to receive it.
Okay, so Pico, thank you for joining us. And there are a couple questions
thank
in the
you.
Chat room that I'll answer on your behalf.
Okay.
Ronnie or somebody asked how far you would travel, and he will travel anywhere for the right price, okay?
For the right price. I like that. CT.
Okay.
Well, I suggest that you come to Selma, Alabama for the 52nd Jubilee Festival, Bridge Crossing Jubilee, and get you a booth and set your chair up, and I guarantee you, you can do some Reiki on me.
He got to wait.
Right. Go pay for the plane ticket.
Right. Okay. So
just give me the details. I'm interested.
We're going to take a break.
First full weekend of March. Pencil it in, but we'll get you more.
We're going to take a break. Nobody has to drop off. We're going to take a break, but I got to get this drop in.
It's beach body season, so if you're looking to get that beach body, there's still time with IASOT. The IASOT is a unique blend of 9 all-natural herbs. Just 8 ounces of tea twice daily can provide you with dramatic results and have you beach ready in no time. Place your order today at www.totallifechanges.com/T-Team. That's www.totallifechanges.com/TEATEAM or call 678-250-5839. That's 678-250-5839. Start working on your beach body today.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. We are back with the Lonely Hearts Cafe. We are back. Now, we got to get on somebody. We got to get on Teresa's ass. Teresa.
What?
How you going to be talking during the damn commercial breaks? If nobody's saying anything.
You hear me talking. I didn't think you could hear me. I was way in the kitchen. My phone was in the living room.
If nobody's talking, it's a message. It's a reason nobody's talking.
Whatever. Sometimes my phone go in and out, so I didn't know if it went back on or whatever. So.
Teresa.
Check it back in.
Teresa.
Yes.
You know what else goes in and out?
Don't answer that, Teresa. All for the trap.
What you must know.
So how are you, Honorable Deacon Aloysius? How are you?
I'm good, man. But there's one other question we forgot to ask him.
Go ahead.
And that's about transgender people. As far as massaging is concerned, does he do that?
Let me see if Pico's still online. Pico, you still online? No, he dropped off. But he's in the chat room. So go ahead and ask your question because he's listening. Pico, if you're listening, respond in the chat room. Go ahead, Deacon Aloysius.
And the if he actually has besides transgender people, and what their requests actually are. I'm pretty sure it's about the same, but, you know, you never know.
Okay, I think he's calling back in. Pico, did you hear that? Did you hear that question, Pico?
I heard the tail end of it. You can run it by me one more time. Sorry, Aloysius.
Go ahead, Aloysius.
Not a problem. I was wondering how many times do you, if massaging transgender people?
You know what? I don't know. I don't know if I've ever run into that. Not of my knowledge.
Not even in Atlanta?
Not even in Atlanta. Now, I've had gay guys.
Because I was about to say, what about transvestites?
I'm going to say, in Atlanta.
I don't know.
In Atlanta, the doctors in Atlanta can do some works of art now.
No. As far as I know, I've just massaged men and women.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, let y'all know this. I am now about to post the link to Don't Lie to Me, the song that you're hearing on the Lonely Hearts Cafe tonight by MC. I am posting the link on iTunes and Amazon for Don't Lie to Me. It is only 99 cents a copy. 99 cents a copy. So he released that song for us to use. And he is from SEL. He's from Selma, 27. So go on and support that young man, MC. 99 cents a copy on Amazon and iTunes. Don't Lie to Me. That's the jam.
I love it. T-shirts too. So I don't know if you want to. They have like a whole little line.
Go if you follow him on Facebook or if you go to his website, you'll see the link for his T-shirts and everything. So that's true. Support him. Support him. Spicy, welcome to the Lonely Hearts Cafe.
Thank you. I just called to say hey. Hey to Aloysius.
Hey, baby. How are you?
That is all. Oh, I'm good. I'm doing great.
Wait. Called to say hey to Aloysius?
Well, I said hey to you about the peacock. Yeah.
But that wasn't you with the peacock.
It certainly was not. Thank you.
Don't say certainly. Like, as an insult, don't be trying to insult that beautiful animal.
Oh, I'm not. No, it's beautiful. She's beautiful.
She damn sure is. I have a cock that pees. Shit.
Wow. So, CT, I'm just saying I have to call in because you were acting up, and I don't want, you know, this affair to get out of hand. So.
Woman. Go ahead, Aloysius. You about to say something?
I was, but then I realized I'm in Michigan and I have to act accordingly.
Say what you're going to say, Aloysius. Because when I start
speaking on my tongue, there should always be love around us at all times.
Damn right. She's getting me heated.
And we need to actually see a full body picture before we go into the overexertion of energy as far as the peacock is concerned, anyway.
Yes, sir. So let me tell you all who are around in the cafe, what's happening right now. You ever been in an environment, a club, a diner, a cafe, and some shit about to jump off between a dude and a female, and the dude's friend says, he gets involved, he says, let's walk away, turn around, walk away? That's what's happening right now.
Just a little love. That's all we need right now. What is the next question, anyway?
Damn right. What's the next question? So, the question is, on a date, Sunshine.
Yeah.
This was for you. Because Spice about to get cursed out. On a date, a guy gives
Hold on,
you.
Wait.
Huh?
Go ahead.
You not ready? Tiana. Teresa.
My phone is dying, so I'm trying to call in on my cell phone.
Hold on, Sunshine. Let me give this one to Teresa. This is a good one for Teresa's ass. Teresa.
Yes?
If you're on a date, somebody wants to know who's playing blues in the background.
Oh, that's not bad. That's Empire. Let me turn the volume down. Sorry.
Okay. They just
turn that shit off.
I'm calling from my other phone because this phone's about to die, so that's me calling you.
Y'all getting both of us hyped tonight. Done pissed Aloysius off and Spicy pissing me off. I don't know what the fuck. But,
it's off. It's off.
Hey, Spicy.
The Empire is the devil.
Did Spicy hang up?
I like the devil's playground.
Spicy,
I'm ready for the question, then, if she's not ready.
Well, let me tell Spicy one more thing.
Uh-oh.
Spicy, remind me to show up at your show tomorrow and take a shit, okay? All right.
All right.
It's not about you. It's not about you.
But we love you, though.
Fuck that shit. All right. You don't call nobody show and make it about you. Who do you think you are? Chief Rocker Jersey Vern? Fuck. All right. So say you're on a date, Teresa, and a guy gives you $25 to gamble.
Okay.
And you lose it. You're at a casino or something like that. He gives you $25 to gamble and you lose it. Then he gives you $25 more and you win $2,000. How much would you give him, if any? That question comes from Randall in Arlington, Texas.
Good question.
Teresa?
First of all, I don't gamble. But if it was that I lost the first 25, I wouldn't gamble anyway. I would put the money in my pocket. Oh, now, if I got the second 25 and I won some money, then it's my money.
Teresa, hold on, Sunshine.
You spindly motherfucker.
I'm spindly. He gave me the money to gamble with, so therefore, what I won, it belongs to me.
Well, if he gave you the gamble with the money to gamble with, what the fuck you doing putting it in your pocket?
No, because he gave it to me.
See?
I didn't have
spindly.
To gamble with it.
You know, we like shoes, you know.
You frugal as hell.
So, Teresa.
See, that's a quick way for him not to fuck with you no more.
That's what I was just about to say. That's what I was just
about
to say.
And that would be fine with me.
No, it wouldn't.
Because he has a gambling problem or something.
No. Okay, first of all, let me echo what Aloysius just said. Teresa, I'm telling you, as long as you have that mentality, you will have a problem not only with men, but you will have a problem in life.
Why is that?
Because, and everybody hold up, give me a Christopher Tracy moment on this one, and then we're going to open it up to everybody else. If you give a person $25 and they bury it, it doesn't grow. If you give a person $25 and they gamble all of it, they could lose all of it.
Okay, if I lost all of it the first time, then I lost it the first time.
So you're not listening.
Then he gave me $25 more, and I won.
You're not
so
listening.
So it grew.
You didn't know he was going to give you the second $25.
Okay, but he didn't know I was going to lose the first $25
so
either.
You're not listening. So you didn't know he was going to give you the second $25. So you mm-hmm. took the money from a person who's not used to having money. You can't grow wealth. It's a whole business side of this. You can't grow wealth. You can't grow, I'm not saying wealthy. I'm saying personal wealth. When you hide it under a bushel, when you bury your money in the sand, it doesn't grow. Okay, there's risk in investment, but there's also reward. I'm not saying that you have to gamble the entire $25. You could put $5 away and you look at the odds, the chances of winning. You decide what you're going to gamble on. But damn, and then you say when he gets to $2,000, you're not going to give him a return on his investment. He could have been investing you in coochie. He could have been investing in you in your wardrobe. He could have been investing in you with time. Time is valuable too. But
well,
you're not going to give him
invest in my time, so therefore.
You're not going to give him anything back?
You're going to cause him to do some strange voodoo to you.
I'm not worried about no voodoo. I'm covered by the blood of Jesus.
I don't know nothing about no blood, but that sounds like voodoo too.
No.
All right. So, Sunshine, how would you handle it? Sunshine, how would you handle it?
Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, I would have given him about 200 of it. Now, I wouldn't have gave him, you know, because he gave me the 50, so I would have doubled it. And because he gave it to me twice, I'd have doubled it again and just been like, okay. And I hope, you know, hopefully he can turn it and we keep flipping money all night. But, you know, I've dated a gambler, and if you go to a casino with a man and he gives you money, he might be a keeper. Because true gamblers ain't going to give you shit. So
that's a good point. That's a good point. I see Spices on the line. Go ahead, say something else. You were saying something else, Sunshine?
First date on the casino, Atlantic City, early, mid-90s. Went, gentleman was fine. I'm talking about fine, Caribbean brother, whatever. He was working at, I think, maybe the Lexus
Sunshine.
Dealership in Manhattan.
Sunshine.
Yes.
Forget it. Forget it. Tiana.
Yeah. I'm trying to explain why I don't like gambling. It was a good story, even though you said fuck it.
You're taking away from masturbating just then, but go ahead.
Tiana.
Yeah.
Hey, Tiana.
Hi.
So, did you hear the question?
Yes, I heard the question.
Would you give the man any money?
I'll be honest with you. If he's giving me the money, say, here, go gamble.
Hold on, let me pause you one more time. Let me pause you one second. I can clear something up in the chat. Ronnie, I said that Teresa.
Pause on me.
Yes, I did. Ronnie, I'm sorry, Tiana, but Spicy put me in that kind of mood, so I apologize to you. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Let's blame it on Spicy. Ronnie, I said that Teresa acted from a position where she was not used to having money, not the dude, because Teresa pocketed the first 25. Okay. Go ahead, Tiana.
Actually, if you give me something, it's a gift. When I give something, I don't expect nothing in return. So, and I gamble from time to time. But I would give him some, but I wouldn't give him half. I would give him some, maybe like $25 to see that he's going to be.
Well, damn. You might as well tell him to kiss your ass when you toss that punky ass $25 at him.
But she didn't have to tell him she wanted $2,000 either.
But I'm not selfish, but you know what I mean, but...
Now, see, that's the question, though. Is the other person around when she actually wins the money?
Well, wins the money, I give him some, yeah.
Okay. $25.
No. I'm saying...
Gas, baby.
I mean, you know...
Breakfast. Buffet money.
Okay. Okay, let's get a man's
perspective. Bologna sandwich.
Aloysius, how much would you expect? How much would you be looking for?
And see, that goes back to the question, did I actually see her win the money, or is it just...
Good question.
You know what I mean? If I saw her actually win it, then... I don't know. Because it's not really ours from the beginning, but goddamn, $25, though. You know what? $2,000. Half would be nice. I would say that half would be nice. Anything over that would be pimp standard.
Come on. What do you think? This is alimony?
No, I'm just saying 90% would be a lot better. No, I'm just saying, not anybody in their right mind would say 90% is a lot better than half. But still, the point is, I would be fine with half. I understand 500, you know, because we didn't have it from the start, like I said. But anything under like that 500 mark is kind of suspect.
Okay. So here's my answer. If she doesn't offer shit, she might need to use some of that money to get her way home.
I know, right?
But when she does offer, I am not going to ask for any. Okay, mm-hmm. She can offer 25, she can offer 100, she can offer 1,000. I'm going to say, nah, you good.
You don't understand. But,
that's a good man. That's a good dude.
But she better give me something. She better just tuck a couple dollars.
You know, we're together at a gambling casino.
Somewhere.
We're together at a gamble, you know, we're at the casino and we're gambling or whatever. And the person gave $25. First of all, the agenda was not to go there and be able to give you money and win money. I mean, yes, of course, if he just gave it to you.
No, you said the agenda was not what?
The agenda, okay, if you're going with someone and they're gambling, and you're just around and say, here, take this and play it. Okay. Are you there to have a good time, or are you there for other reasons?
What are the other
reasons? Do people really have good times in casinos?
Hell, I do.
Good question.
What are the other reasons?
I mean, you have any time, you enjoy each other. So okay. If I give someone something, I don't expect anything in return. If they don't give it back to me, that's on them. You know, no sleep lost.
Pico also wants to know, what are the other reasons? What are the other reasons other than a good time to go to casino?
I mean, some folks go gambling. Anybody, hey, just win this money. And, you know, just win this money. But if you don't have an agreement that we don't go here, I'm going to give this money. If you win, I get half. If that is not the agreement, then you shouldn't expect anything in return.
But you don't do that on a date. On a date, you don't set terms and say, how are we going to split it?
But you know what? Some people do. But you know what, Mr. Tracy?
That's
you know
hustling.
What, Tracy? Sometimes I do.
That's a, okay. I feel you.
Is that hustling? Yeah. You got to get it
somewhere.
It's
not a romantic date. Some people go to the casino for a romantic date. All right. So the other thing I want to throw in this too, and before we transition, good topic, you guys, and good discussion. The other thing I want to throw out there too is sometimes a man will give the woman money because in the event that her luck is better than his. So he's basically saying, okay, I think she might have better luck, better karma than me. I'm going to give this to her so she can win. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Go home as close to even as possible.
Lady luck, let's go home tonight. But I doubt it.
Okay, here's a good one. I know what Aloysius' answer is going to be. I'm interested in hearing. Okay, I'm going to tell everybody in the chat room how this was going to go off the bat. Aloysius is going to not give a fuck. Sunshine is going to give an honest answer. Tiana is going to lie. So whatever Tiana says is actually going to be the opposite. And Teresa will give us a partial answer, but she won't give us the full answer. And Pico, I think Pico's still on the line. Pico's still on the line. Pico, Pico will tell us the answer, and then all the ladies in the chat room will fall in love with him. All right? So here's the question. Would you feel some type of way if the person you were talking to did not accept your friend request on Facebook? That question comes from Shandidra out of Atlanta. Would you feel some type of way if the person that you were talking to did not accept your friend request on Facebook? Aloysius. Shout out to Dollars and Cents. Shout out to Dollars and Cents.
You're absolutely right. I surely wouldn't give a fuck. I really would. In fact, I've blocked most of the women that have been trying to get close with me as far as Facebook is concerned. That's why I'm so glad that my shit is at the limit. I really am.
That's why you're so glad your shit is what?
At the limit. I can't accept any more friend requests anyway.
Well, damn.
Yeah, so.
Go ahead.
Shout out to Aloysius Forever Love.
Fuck all that shit, man. Because, you know, I don't want to see anybody else's boyfriend, ex-boyfriend, all in their business anyway. You know, I can give a fuck less.
Okay.
And I don't want them spying on me. Shit.
Okay, we got about 20 minutes left in the show tonight. Let's go to Sunshine.
Good question.
I know it's a good damn question.
It causes problems. So I have, like, once I realize I like this person, because, you know, my, like, you know, Aloysius, our Facebook pages can lead people to think other things outside of who we actually are.
Wait. So let me pause you, because you're going in the wrong direction. You're going in the wrong direction.
I'm going to be honest. I'm going to restrict them.
No.
I'm going to let them be my Facebook. He blocked me.
No. You're answering the question from what the perspective of what you would do. I'm saying if you send him a friendship request and he didn't accept
it. If I wasn't his friend initially, I wouldn't give a shit. You know what I mean? Because I know it causes problems.
Ronnie says, if the person you're talking to doesn't accept your friend request on Facebook, either they're afraid that you will not, that you will nitpick them, hold on, that you will nitpick them about everything anyone of the opposite sex says or likes,
exactly.
Or they have something to hide. And Bus a Bus says that's true. Grego says Al is a celeb, and Aloysius is indeed a celebrity. Okay, caller from the 678 area code. We will get to you in a second. Stay ready. If you stay ready, you ain't got to get ready by the master sugar free. All right. So,
okay.
Let's see.
Tell her stuff.
Tiana.
Yes.
How would you feel if a dude didn't accept your request?
I mean, I'll feel some type of way because if we're dealing with each other, why not our friendship if we're both two mature adults? But some people can be stalkers.
Okay, so she answered the question, honestly, you all. She said she would feel some type of way. I know Tiana has a sensitive side, so I thought she was going to try to be hard and say, I wouldn't care. Okay. Good job. Okay.
Yes.
Teresa. Pep it up. I'm going to pass you up. How would you feel?
It would be whatever.
Didn't I tell y'all Teresa gonna give us a half-assed answer?
It would be. I wouldn't. Hey, no love lost.
Tiana.
Yes.
How would Teresa feel if the dude didn't accept her friend request?
I don't think she would care. Okay. But she don't sweat things like that.
Okay. I just wanted to hear the real answer. I knew Teresa wasn't going to give us a real answer.
I did.
Okay, we had a caller. Pico, stay on the line. I'm coming to you next. We had a caller from the 678 area code. Who was that?
Did everybody order pizza?
I knew it was Chief Rocker time. Let me tell y'all, Chief Rocker sit by the clock. Itching. Chief Rocker. Let me let Pico go first, because I know you got a good answer for us. Pico.
What's up?
How would you feel if the lady didn't accept your friend request?
You know what? We're gonna take a trip to Spain. I'm gonna eat the groceries.
What?
Take that kitty from the
front to
the back.
Wait. Get
and we ain't gonna trip on the social media thing like that.
hold on. Pause. Get close to the microphone. All I heard you say was you're gonna eat her groceries.
Yeah, I'm at the corner. We're gonna take a trip to Spain, right? I'm gonna eat that kitty from the front to the back, eat the groceries, and we ain't gonna trip on none of that social media stuff right there.
Damn right.
That's fancy. I ain't got nothing to do with that.
Chief Rocker, don't say shit yet. Don't say shit yet, Chief Rocker. Aloysius, what's your response to that?
I'm at the corner and I'm lost. Shit.
Okay, so let me fill it in. Chief Rocker, don't say shit yet. Let me fill it in. Pico, why the fuck you gonna do all that shit? What you talking about?
Right.
Okay, now, the scenario was everybody was going to give a perspective from different views. So this is just my view to make all the ladies in the chat room melt.
We don't want that. We want your honest answer.
Oh, my honest answer? You know what? Honest answer. I've been in a relationship dealing with Facebook, people hitting you in your inbox telling you stuff about your girl. You're like, whoa.
Pico.
So I think it's really, I'm a, not to go all off the board, but I really wouldn't want my significant other corresponding on social media.
Okay.
Honestly,
with you or with others? With you or with others? Do you want to, like, corresponding with you or with others?
No, I'm saying you can have my own Facebook and I can have my own Facebook. And I'm
exactly.
Cool with that. Okay. Yeah, it's just like, it's too much drama. I didn't just, like, see too much drama. And if people are post stuff on people's pics just to agitate them.
Yeah.
You have yours, I have mine. I have my phone, you have your phone. I'm not going through yours, I'll go through mine. Like that. Thanks.
Let me tell you, Aloysius got me in trouble last year behind our little crazy-ass post, so keep them off your damn page. If you want it to work, keep them off your shit.
Yes, yes, indeed. Keep them off your page.
Oh, shit. Damn.
And then you can still go on a trip to Spain.
When the calendar changes, you leave the shit in the previous year. You don't bring that shit into this year.
I'm just talking past experience, and it taught me a lesson. Don't give
that's
it
reality.
Ronnie says, in a relationship, I don't need to be a part of every single aspect of his life.
Amen.
Okay. Let's see. What's going on here? Hold on. Who's calling from 910 area code?
It's me. My phone died.
Well, damn. You resurrected that motherfucker pretty quickly. Let's see. Okay, Queen B says, on the defensive side, he may not be ready to share his woman with others. That can be because, mm-hmm. The chat's moving, that can be because he doesn't want people in his inbox with drama or trying to figure out who she is. I mean, does social media make a relationship weaker? Keep nosy ass people off your page. And I feel that.
I mean, I agree because, you know, I like taking selfies. So I had a friend, and when people would comment on my post good morning or whatever, it would blow him through the roof. I was like, damn, it's only a good morning.
They become stalker-like and vice versa. Mm-hmm.
So he's like, you're writing good morning, love. And then he's like, hi, sexy, hi, beautiful. I'm like, but it's just good morning. So he has to delete me off his page. And I'll be like, oh, my God.
Okay, Easy Does It says it goes down in the DM. Spicy says hers is blowing up right now, as if anybody gives a fuck. I done told Spicy about bringing her shit here. Spicy, keep a tally, get you a pen, a piece of paper, and draw little lines for every DM message that you get. And then on tomorrow night on your show, announce that shit. Okay?
Oh, yeah. Posting
your chat.
Alright?
Period. Hell.
I love my classmates. Are y'all coming to the class reunion, by the way?
Do I ever come?
That's that bullshit. We never had one. We were so fucking off the chain, we never had one because we had our own social media. No, it's not.
Right.
I'll take the blame, though.
All right.
But we had one in the back of the field.
I'll be in the
city.
With
the goats.
All right. Okay, so let's see. We got one or two left. Let's see. Do we want to go through these? Okay. Tiana.
Yes.
Can you stay in a relationship with a person that does not please you sexually?
Yeah.
Teresa, Can you? Sunshine, can you?
Hell to the fuck no. Yeah. No. No.
What if you're married to someone and their dick falls off or something like that?
We got to go see Pico.
Well, that's it, Josie.
Well, I forgot T-Rocker was on the line. Hold on, T-Rocker. I'm gonna give you. I'm gonna let you get in. I got you, T-Rocker. Hold on, Pico. Pico dropped off. Aloysius, can you stay in a relationship with someone that, who doesn't please you sexually?
I'm taking it back to Selma with a N-A-W-L.
No.
All
right. I could. Because I just think it goes back to what I said earlier. There are more things in a relationship than sex.
You just killed yourself.
You just said ass and butt, hips and butt now.
If to the eye. It's pleasing to the eye. Because remember, the stud is not going to want me.
Oh, okay. I think you're full of shit, though. But hey.
Okay. I'm not denying that. All right. Chief Rocker Jersey Vern, good evening.
Good evening. How's everybody doing?
Jersey.
Well, baby.
What's up, baby? Yeah, Jersey definitely in the house.
Who's playing there? Somebody needs to turn their radio down in the background. It's probably you, Jersey.
Huh?
Turn your radio down.
That ain't me.
It's always
me.
Who said that?
See?
Tiana.
Now, CT, you know who that is every week.
You're right.
You're right. Every week.
Her phone be sounding like a casino ringing and everything.
I know.
So, Chief Rocker, could you be in a relationship with somebody who doesn't please you sexually?
Nah, bro. I don't know how you just sat there and said that. Because wasn't the thing before was you test it when you first get married. So if it's good, right, you stay with it. But when it go bad, I mean, you can keep up, but shit, I'm going to be out there dipping and dabbing.
So, Chief Rocker, the question was, could you stay in a relationship? If you dipping and dabbing, you still in that relationship.
I mean, you in a relationship or marriage, which one you wanted to be?
It's the don't put words in my mouth.
Difference. It's
the
a difference.
Question said relationship.
All right. Well, if it's a relationship, I'm moving on. You know what I'm saying? Okay. I'm like Papa was a Rolling Stone. You know what I'm saying? My bag's always packed.
Damn.
I hear you.
Wait. Jeez. Oh,
and now they got the lady turn on wheels. What about what now, baby? What's that, son?
You can't, like, give
you
a little
right.
pointers.
You said it right the first time, Chief Rocker. You said baby.
That's right. That's right.
Okay.
I can't wait till you come to Atlanta. We're gonna meet up. But look, what if you can't teach it whatever you like?
Do I have to what now?
Say that again. Why wouldn't you just teach her what she's lacking? Well, baby,
I mean, if we talking about right now, baby. I'm too old to teach. If they come to me, right, they better know what they're doing. If they don't know what they're doing, I ain't got the time to teach no more. Teaching is over with.
Okay. You're right. I was just being curious.
Oh, yeah, curiosity. You always kill the cat, but I hope it don't kill that cat.
Jersey.
The cat ain't dead.
Jersey, how many times a month do you use that line right there?
Which one?
Curiosity don't kill the cat, but I hope.
Nah, you ain't never heard me say that, man. You know what? You've been calling me out all through the chat today. You know what I'm saying? You just put Jersey on blast. You know, probably because your homegirl there, and she from Jersey, and you know he was in the same neck of the woods. That's what it is. That's what it is, CT.
Jersey, who told you she was from Jersey? Did I tell you that?
Chatting it up. We chatted up.
Jersey.
What up?
I'm playing your theme song.
Oh, okay. That's what's up, man. That's definitely what's up. You know,
calm down. You okay, Jersey?
Oh, I'm definitely great, son. It's been a great day. We had a great night last night, and it was a blast all day today.
Shout out to
the like
microwave.
The Iron Man.
Glad the microwave is back. Okay, so last week's show, we got cut off. So we're going to make sure we don't get cut off tonight. So Chief Rocker, go ahead and say goodbyes to everyone.
Okay, so we're all in the house. I know Sunshine is in the house.
Jersey.
Tiana's in the house.
Jersey.
Oh, you know what, Tiana?
Jersey.
Yeah. Hi.
We running out of time. Huh? Say what you got to say.
Okay. Tiana, the picture's looking good of you, baby. I mean, whoever's in the house, Al in the house, who's up, Al? Keep doing what you're doing, bro. You're getting better every week, man. That's real. And CT, you have a great day, bro. I'll see you on the rebound.
Appreciate you, Chief Rocker Jersey Vern, joining us.
Yes, sir.
All right. Number one, Chief Rocker.
That's right. Make sure you get that right now. I'll holler.
Because if he wasn't number one, he'd be the assistant chief. All right. Cool, but hip hop and rap, yeah, that's where my heart's at. Even back when I used to break on a box. Backspin for backspin. All right.
Huh? Like out there?
Sunshine.
I just wanted, I enjoyed, since it's been like almost a year since I've been on, I really enjoyed my night tonight, and I'll be back. I forgot how fun it was on the Lonely Hearts Cafe. Good night, everybody.
Thank you. Okay. Teresa?
Good night, everyone.
Okay, that's it?
Yes, that's it.
Okay.
Tiana? Shout out to MC.
Yeah, shout out to MC. Thank you. Tiana?
Hi. Good night, everyone. I'm Black Kennedy. I will talk to you guys. Can't see. And Chris the Tracy, I'm sure you'll put me on pause again.
Tiana?
Yes.
Hold on a second.
Yeah, okay. Right. Okay, now Deacon Aloysian and Denise and Sunshine, everyone else, and Ronnie. And Chief Rocker, Jersey. Have a good night.
Tiana.
Yes.
Call him Assistant Chief Rocker.
Assistant Chief Rocker. Will do. There you go.
Pico.
What up?
Say goodbye to everybody. Thank you for joining us tonight. Say goodbye to everybody.
Everybody have a great night. It was a pleasure being on the Lonely Hearts Cafe. You know, we get a little new edition played next time, you know. But thank you. Thank you so much. Peace and love.
That's right. You do want new edition played. We'll see what we can do for you.
All right.
We got you. I'll holler at you and see what you want to hear.
All right.
Peace. Okay. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Deacon Aloysius, Forever Love.
It's been a stone cold groove, ladies and gentlemen. Remember to be thankful for your blessings, and your trials are only a testing. So move forward into the universe.
Indeed. Mandelion. Mandelion, thank you for joining us. Just joined to the chat room late. Everybody that was in the chat room, we had a whole crew in the chat room. Chief Rocker Jersey Vern, Denise, Ronnie from Sheboygan, Jamie was in there, Sandra was in there, Tiffany from Atlanta, Pico, follow him, LP Show, Spicy from Spicy Conversations, Easy Does It was very active, thank you. Queen B from Louisville, thank you for joining us. Who else we got? Y'all help me out. 334 Bama Boy from the Gump down here in Florida. Shout out to you. I'm still going through. Don't want to miss anybody. Dollars and Cents from Kalamazoo, Michigan. Shout out to you. And your label mate, Your partner who was absent tonight, the sports governor, Vince Wright. Cowpoke joined us. Jeff, thank you for joining us and lightening up the show. Denise from the 27, thank you for joining us. Busser from Oklahoma, thank you for joining us. Grego and Sluggo. Grego makes you prego. Grego was in the house. Okay. Denise, Ronnie said them. Jamie mentioned Jamie. I'm scrolling through quickly, everybody. Didn't want that ninja joined us from Huntsville. Huntsville, Alabama in the house. Sosa joined us. Sosa, I don't know where you were from, sweetheart. Empress was joined us, definitely. And we had a few other people from Sheboygan, I know, that joined us that I'm missing. But I don't want to miss anybody. And Mandeleon is in Atlanta. So, everybody, thank you. And we are going to go out tonight. This is Christopher Tracy. Join us every Wednesday. Shout out to SME. Doug Stewart and Stewart Media Entertainment Network. Follow SME. Follow us. Join us live every Wednesday. And we're going to wrap the show. This is Christopher Tracy. And for my partner, I shouldn't say that. For my co-host, the Honorable Deacon Aloysius Forever Love. Good night, everyone. And thank you for joining us.
I'm CEO.
One beat maker, the hit maker, real, right? The hit maker.
I'm CEO. Yeah. Money all day, every day. Money all day, every day. Somebody gotta keep it real, right?
You're listening to Team Broadcasting.
So, what are we gonna do now? Just sit around and be bored?